Choice Radio. Study his word so you can grow. Choice Radio. Choice Radio. Your life, your salvation, your choice. Jesus is Lord.
Praise the Lord. Pleasant good morning to all in Radio Land. This is Salvation and Revelation Evangelist Jennifer Pope. And this is the day that the Lord has made. No matter what situations you're going through, The word of God said we must rejoice. In all things we give him thanks. In all things we praise his name. He said pray always. So today, even as we come before the throne room of grace, we want to just bless the Lord for waking us up this morning. We're in the land of the living, and it's a blessing. Shall we pray? Father, we come before your throne of grace, O God, and we say thank you, O God, Father, for just the opportunity that we have another day, O God, in which we can praise you, we can bless you, we can live for you, we can bring you glory, O God. We say thank you, O God, for taking us through another night, another week, O God, and we ask you, O God, Father, even as we come into your presence, O God, we ask you, O God, to cleanse us, O God, from all unrighteousness. Wash us white as snow, O God, creating us a clean heart and a right spirit for today, O God. We ask you, O God, to cover us in your blood, O God. We ask you, O God, Father, Lord God, that your blood soak us this morning, O God, that we will live aright for you, O God. Father, we just want to say thank you for salvation this morning. Thank you, O God, by you send your son Jesus, O God. By through him we are saved, O God. We have, O God, a gift, O God, a precious gift, salvation, O God. And we say thank you for salvation this morning. Thank you for access to your throne room of grace, O God. Father, we thank you, O God, for your son Jesus. We ask you, Lord God, not by might, not by power, but by your spirit, O God. For those who have just tuned in this morning, O God, to Choice Gospel Radio, that something, O God, in your word would draw them to you today, O God, Lord Jesus. Something, O God, in a song would minister to someone's spirit this morning, O God. Something, O God, Father, Lord God, will draw, O God, and we know it's by the power of your Holy Spirit. So we ask you, Holy Spirit, to be present in the studio on today in the name of Jesus. We ask you to take control of our mouths, O God, that it will bring glory unto your son Jesus, O God. We ask you, Holy Spirit, O God, to anoint us afresh, O God. All those who are coming into the station, O God, this morning, O God, I ask you to prepare them with your anointing in the name of Jesus, to break yokes today in the name of Jesus, that your word shall go forth on today in power, in might, in conviction, O God, and the Holy Spirit, O God, will bring souls to your kingdom in the name of Jesus. We have no power of our own, O God. So we ask you, Father, to energize us with your anointing, O God, that, O God, the words of our mouth, the meditation of our heart will be acceptable unto you, our God, our Savior, and our Redeemer. Amen and amen. Jesus Christ is Lord. Today, even as we come before the throne room of grace, we want the Lord to know that we love him. And whatever is your situation, Jesus Christ is Lord. He's on the throne. He's sitting at the right hand of the Father making intercessions for you. Amen. He wants you to trust him with all your heart. Don't lean on to your own understanding. Everything that you do, acknowledge God, and he shall direct your path. Amen and amen. Praise the Lord. Today we're going to pray a prayer, Lord God, for not just for ourselves, but there are people who are hurting, there are people who are sick, there are people who has tough, stubborn problems. So we're gonna ask God to meet his people at the point of their need. Shall we pray? Father, in the name of Jesus, you know every person you have created, O God. We did not create ourselves, O God. You know, O God, Father, the stress, you know the strain, you know the infirmity, the sickness, the disease, the trouble, O God, that face your people, O God, the body of Christ on today, O God. We know those, O God, who you have called, but they have not yet arrived and make a decision to enter into rest with you. I ask you to remember them too in the name of Jesus. I ask you, O God, Father, to bring solution, bring, O God, resolution to problems, O God. Father, Lord God, those who are inflicted with drug addiction, O God. O God, Father, with habits, O God, stubborn problems, O God. I ask you to touch them on today. I ask you, O God, to send your Holy Spirit, O God, to do a new thing, O God. Those who are sick in the hospitals, O God, in their homes, O God, in nursing facilities and other outreach programs, O God, I ask you to meet them, O God. Change them, O God. Send helpers, O God, for them, O God, in the name of Jesus. Connect them to their connectors, O God. Each one that has, O God, Father, your name written, O God, that you have assigned, O God, Father. You have called, O God, and you have chosen, O God. I ask you, O God, to connect them to their connectors in the name of Jesus for blessings and for breakthrough, O God. I ask you, O God, to send angels with healing on their wings, O God, to touch those who are sick, O God. I, O God, remember those who are sick in the mind, O God, emotional financial problems, oh God, depression, oh God, psychological issues, oh God. I ask you, oh God, Father, because you have not given us a spirit of fear, but a spirit of love, of power, and a sound mind, oh God. I decree soundness upon minds today in the name of Jesus, that your people will think aright, oh God, in the name of Jesus. They shall have matching behavior patterns in the name of Jesus. I ask you, oh God, to draw, not by might, not by power, but by your spirit. Draw someone to you today, oh God, who is at the verge of giving up, that they will know that you are Lord. I ask you to speak to some heart today, oh God, that they will reach out to this station, oh God. And even as, oh God, Father, they tune in on their app, on their phone, oh God, or even as they're driving in their car, oh God, that this word, oh God, something that would be said today, oh God, will draw them, oh God, into relationship with you. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. It's not by might, it's not by power, but everything is done by your spirit. Jesus Christ is Lord. Amen and amen. Jesus is coming again, and he wants you to be rapture ready. He wants you to turn over your heart, your life to him on today. Today is the day of salvation. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Father, in the name of Jesus, oh God, even as your people listen on this morning, oh God, I ask you to send your anointing, oh God, to break yokes, oh God, that your family, oh God, the family, the body of Christ, oh God, will know the time, the season, oh God, that we are in, oh God. We are living in your last days, oh God. And Father, help us, oh God, Father, to be busy with kingdom duties in the name of Jesus. I ask you, oh God, to draw again, draw not by might, not by power, but by your spirit, oh God, that our lives will be lived on purpose, oh God. We will be living, oh God, on purpose for you, oh God, because we are truly living in the last days. And I bless you and I thank you, oh God, for bringing, oh God, a fire under your people, oh God, for souls, oh God. You said, he that wins souls is wise, oh God. Give us wisdom to bring souls into your kingdom, for redemption draweth nigh. Amen and amen. There is no God like Jehovah. His greatness, his power, his glory, his majesty. There is no God like Jehovah. He's coming back again. He wants to take you with him. But it begins with getting over to the other side, which is salvation. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. He's coming back again, and he wants you to be ready. Amen. He came and he left the Holy Spirit, which is the comforter that draws us to him. And if this morning the Holy Spirit is speaking to your spirit man, and you are feeling a nudge in your spirit that, you know, I should change my life, do it today, because tomorrow is not promised to us. The word of God is already blessed. It's taken from Psalm 103, verse 1 to 17. Amen. And I always advise that when the word of God is being read, taught, or preached, that you make note of what is being heard or what you hear, because many false prophets and false teachers have gone out into the world, and you do not want to be deceived. So the best teacher is the Holy Spirit, and he needs you to search the word. He told Joshua, study the word day and night so that you will make your way prosperous and that you will have good success. So we have that power by the Holy Spirit to make our way prosperous and have good success. It begins with the word. Amen. Praise the Lord. Psalm 103, beginning from verse 1. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits, who forgiveth all thy iniquities, who healeth all thy diseases, who redeemeth thy life from destruction, who crowneth thee with loving kindness and tender mercies, who satisfy thy mouth with good things, so that thy youth is renewed like the eagle. The Lord executeth righteousness and judgment for all that are oppressed. He made known his ways unto Moses, his acts upon the children of Israel. The Lord is merciful and gracious, slow to anger, and plenteous in mercies. He will not always chide, neither will he keep his anger forever. He has not dealt with us after our sins, nor rewarded us according to our iniquities. For as the heaven is high above the earth, so great is his mercy towards them that fear him. Amen. As far as the east is from the west, so far has he removed our transgressions from us. Amen. Like as a father pities his children, so the Lord pities them that fear him. For he knoweth our frame, for he remembereth that we are dust. As for man, his days are as grass, as a flower of the field, so he flourishes. For the wind passeth over it, and it is gone, and the place thereof shall know it no more. But the mercy of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting upon them that fear him, and his righteousness unto his children's children. Amen. This is the word of the Lord. His righteousness, his mercies endures forever. Amen. And we never know what great a God he is until we receive him as Lord and Savior. He might be kind to you now, but when you know that joy of salvation is when you turn your life over to Jesus Christ, and he breaks the chains that is holding you back in your life. He breaks the power of Satan. There are chains that hold us in bondage, and he wants to break every chain this morning. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. There's power in his name. Whatever you're going through this morning, just know there's power in the name of Jesus. And he's here to break every chain, break every hole, whatever is holding you back, whatever is keeping you down, whatever is pressing you down, be it if it's your health, if it's wealth, if it's your job, whatever, it's a supervisor, whatever situations that is holding you down. God knows that all he wants you to do is open up your heart to him and receive him today as Lord and Savior. Receive Jesus Christ as your Lord, and he will break every chain in Jesus' name. He has the power. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. There is power in the name of Jesus. And today he wants to give you the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Whatever, you know, life is not a bed of roses. Amen. Life has troubles, situations, trials, temptations, all those things that compasses life. And Jesus came and he went through it, and we are going to go through some things. Amen. It is not just about a prosperity gospel that you give your life to Christ and everything becomes heaven on earth. No. He said he will go through some stuff, and we're going to look at the word of God today and see the things that we're going to go through, but we are going to come out because Jesus Christ is Lord. Amen. You may be in a tight corner this morning, and before even we go into the word, I'm just going to just go into the scriptures again, into Psalm 77. Praise the Lord. This was David, a man after God's own heart, and here's what he was going through. Psalm 77 said, I cried unto the Lord with my voice, even unto God with my voice, and he gave ear unto me. In the day of my trouble I sought the Lord, and so my soul ran in the night and ceased not. My soul refused to be comforted. I remembered God and was troubled. I complained, and my spirit was overwhelmed. Selah. Thou holdest my eyes awakening. I am so troubled that I cannot speak. I've considered the days of old, the years of ancient time. I call to remembrance my song in the night. I commune with my own heart, and my spirit made diligent search. Will the Lord cast me off forever? David was asking that question. Has God forgotten him? He said, and will he be favorable no more? Is his mercy clean gone forever? Does his promise fail forevermore? Has God forgotten to be gracious? Has he in anger shut up his tender mercies? And I said, this is my infirmity, but I will remember the years of the right hand of the Most High. I will remember the works of the Lord. Surely I will remember the wonders of old. I will meditate also of all thy works and talk of thy doings. Thy way, O God, is in the sanctuary. Who is so great a God as our God? Thou art the God that doeth wonders. Thou hast declared thy strength among the people. Thou hast thine arm redeemed the by thy arm redeemed the people, the sons of Jacob and Joseph. The waters saw thee, O God, the waters saw thee. They were afraid. The depth also were troubled. The clouds poured out water. The sky sent out a sound. Thy arrows also went abroad. The voice of thy thunder was in the heavens. The lightnings lightened the world. The earth trembled and shook. Thy way is in the sea, and thy path is in the great waters. Thy footsteps are not known. Thou leadest thy people like a flock by the hands of Moses and Aaron. I'm going to read verse 15. It said, thou hast with thine arm redeemed thy people, the son of Jacob and Joseph. And verse 19 said, thy way is in the sea, and thy path is in the great waters, and thy footsteps are not known. This is the word of the Lord, Psalm 77. Praise the Lord. Whatever situations that you're going through this morning, amen, you still have a reason to praise the Lord, because God said in his word that he has redeemed us. Amen and amen. You can turn your Bibles to Isaiah 43. And if I would choose a title for this message or this teaching today, it's just the simple thing that Jesus Christ is Lord. God is God. Amen? God is God. Simple. God is God. Jesus Christ is Lord over all and over everything. Praise the Lord. I'm going to read Isaiah 43, verse 1 to verse 5. It said, but now thus said the Lord that created thee, O Jacob, and he that formed thee, O Israel, fear not, for I have redeemed thee. I have called thee by thy name. Thou art mine. When thou pass through the waters, I will be with thee. And through the rivers, thou shalt not overflow upon thee. When thou walk through the fire, thou shalt not be burnt, neither shall the flame kindle upon thee. For I am the Lord thy God, the Holy One of Israel, thy Savior. I gave Egypt for thy ransom, Ethiopia and Seba for thee. Since thou wast precious in my sight, thou hast been honorable, and I have loved thee. Therefore will I give men for thee, and people for thy life. Amen. He says, since thou wast precious in thy sight, thou hast been honorable, and I have loved thee. Therefore will I give men for thee and people for thy life. Amen. And this morning, for somebody who's sick this morning, you know, God has given us all power belong to God. For those who are brokenhearted this morning, amen. Jesus Christ is Lord and God is love. Amen. And as he said, when we pass through the waters, he will be with us. Amen. But he said, I want you someone to know this morning, according to Psalm 118, verse 17. Psalm 118, you will not die, you will live and declare the glory of the Lord. Amen. You have to confess it. You have to decree it. The Bible said we can decree a thing and it shall come to pass. And this morning, whatever you are going through, if it's in your body, for someone who is sick, and the Lord wants you to say it and speak it out into the atmosphere, I shall not die, I shall live and declare the glory of the Lord. Whatever situations in your life that seem dead, could be financial situation, could be personal situation with your relationships, whatever it is, know that God is saying to you this morning, it is not dead, it shall rise again. Amen. Amen, amen. He has resurrection power. He rose, he took Lazarus, who was stinking in a grave, and he became alive. Amen. He came out of that grave and he lived again. He went into the grave himself, Jesus Christ, for us. He died on the cross of Calvary, went into a grave. A big stone, huge stone was placed at the entrance so he would not get out of that grave. But guess what? The power of God, it rolled, he was God, the soul was rolled away, and there was an empty tomb. There was nobody in the tomb. Jesus was risen. He has been risen, and he's sitting at the right hand of the Father, making intercessions for you. Amen. And as we look into the scripture, we said, Isaiah 43 said, now thus said the Lord that created thee. The first thing we have to know is that you have not created yourself. You were a created being by a mighty God. He said, the Lord spoke those words. He said, I have created thee. So the first thing you have to know that you were created by a master God. Amen. A God who is majestic, a God who is all-knowing, a God who is all-powerful, a God who sits high, and he created all things both in heaven and in earth. You are created. You are not have a mistake. You came into the world and he created you for a divine purpose. The main purpose he has created you, besides the things that you think that are most important, the main thing he created you for is to have relationship with him and to give him glory. And as you have relationship with him through receiving his son Jesus Christ, through salvation, amen, when you say, yes, Jesus Christ, I acknowledge you as my Lord and Savior, he comes into your heart and he lives there forever. He washes your sins away. Whatever you have done in your past, in your present, whatever you're going to do in times to come, he has cleansed you. He has written your name in heaven that hell shall not be your portion. Because the reason that he created you, I said, was to give him glory, to have a relationship with him. And since God is an eternal God, he wants you to have eternal life with him so that you can give him glory. Amen and amen. Praise the Lord. So you have to first remember that you are created by God and you are created with a purpose. Amen. He said, O Jacob, and he that formed thee, O Israel, fear not. The next thing you have to remember, that no matter what you are going through in your life, no matter what situations you are facing, we are living in terrible times. We are living in end times. People are losing their jobs, losing their health, losing things that are important to them. That when we look at the news, so many disasters with the weather conditions, you know, people just driving in a car, you know, blackout condition, they just lost their car because, you know, they got into accidents on the highway, and situations change in our lives. Amen. We have situations, floods in the Midwest that change many people's life. Hundreds, thousands of people's lives have been changed because of climatic conditions. Amen. There are people's lives who are changed on a one-to-one basis, just being going to on the way, you know, doing the things that they want to do, and maybe some wicked person or some lawless person come and cause conflict or cause accidents or incidents in their lives that maybe lead some of them to death through shooting, through slashing, and some of the things that is happening all around us. God wants us to know this morning that fear not. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. To God be praised. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. To God be praised. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. The Lord wants us to know that we should not be afraid. Amen. We should not be afraid. No matter what you're going through, He has not given us a spirit of fear, but of love, of power, and of a sound mind. Amen. Praise the Lord. He has not given us a spirit of fear, but of love, of power, and of a sound mind. Praise the Lord. Jesus Christ is Lord, and we have to praise Him. Amen. We have to praise Him in our situation. Let the name of the Lord be praised. Amen. Whatever you're going through, when the praises go up, the blessings will come down. You must not be afraid, because He said He's with you. He will never leave you. He will never forsake you. Your condition may change. Your situation may be looking bleaker, maybe looking hopeless. But God wants you to know this morning that His name is to be praised. In all things, give Him thanks. Amen. Let the name of the Lord be glorified in your life. When the praises go up, the blessings will come down. He doesn't want you to be afraid, because He said in His word, do not be afraid of what man can do to you. Be afraid of the one who can destroy both your body and your soul and your spirit, man. And we must have a reverent fear of God, which is a holy respect, a genuine respect for His word. Amen. We want to please Him in everything that we do. We want to give Him glory. We want our lives to be resting in Him. Amen. When we are afraid, it means that we are not trusting Him. So He's saying here, fear not. He's giving you an instruction. Do not be afraid. Your sickness, your disease, your poverty, your insufficiency, the children that is giving you trouble, that you think they are not going to be saved. God is saying, fear not. I promise I will never leave you nor forsake you. I promise I will save you and your household. I promise that I will restore the years that the locust has eaten. I promise that I was wounded for your transgressions. I was bruised for your iniquities. Everything that disturbs your peace, it's upon me. That's why I died. And by my stripes, you are healed. You were healed. I did it over 2,000 years ago. He wants you to claim that promise now. Do not be afraid. He said, whose report will you believe? Are you going to be really believing the reports of your friend, of your situation, of Satan? He said, when we go to the doctor, we get a report. But you can use your faith and say, this is the report. Yes, this is a fact. But I choose to believe the report of the Lord, which says that there is nothing impossible with God, which says that if I have some small faith as a grain of mustard seed, this mountain shall be removed. I can have some small faith, because you gave me an instruction in your word that the just shall live by faith. Amen. So you want to first of all be justified. How do you do that? You have to give your life to Christ. You have to be in the righteousness of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is Lord, and He wants to be first place in your life. When you put Him first place, everything else shall be added unto you. The healing that you want, it's going to be there for, it's there for you. But you must receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. It does not mean that He would not save you. He would not heal you if you don't give your life to Christ. Because He said in His word, I reign on the just and I reign on the unjust. So you may feel that things are happening in your life and everything is good. You are not having any problems like those that have been stated here. But whatever situations you might be enjoying the best of life, because God said in His word, I am a God who is going to reign on the just and on the unjust, which means He's going to bless Those who are saved, he's going to bless those who are not saved too. Amen. Because he's the God of all. Amen. But it does not mean that you don't need a salvation. You don't need a savior. You don't need eternal life. Because hell is not a place you would like to go when you leave this world. As you take a chance and you go into the subway, and there's one man who is conducting a train going into the city, and you trust your life with this train, it's going into the city with one person conducting that train, that one person driving that train, and you're going to make sure that you're going to get to your destination. You are not believing in your heart that you will sleep in that subway. Amen. You are believing that you will get to your destination. As you take a chance getting on the train and trusting that one man, who almost anything can happen while you're on the train. Amen. And God wouldn't, that shall not be your portion in Jesus' name. But I'm just showing you reality. That man can have a heart attack on that while he's driving. He can have a stroke while he's driving. Anything can happen. Amen. He can be held up. Anything can happen. But we cover everyone who drives trains and buses, and that they will get to their destination safely in Jesus' name. But I'm saying to you this morning that you trust that man that he will take you there safely. Why don't you trust Jesus Christ that he will take you into eternity safely, that you will not end up in a Christless eternity? Why do you gamble with your soul and believe that, I don't believe that those things about heaven and hell. I don't believe. It's not what you believe. It's what the Word of God said. And what the Word of God said is what we should believe, which is that there is a place of eternal damnation, a place called hell, and where Satan, who was a created being, who was thrown out of his heaven because he was competing with God, now he's going to pull you into a Christless eternity if you do not give your life to Christ. There is a heaven, a place. When you say yes to Jesus, he's the only way, the only truth, and the only life. When you say yes to him, he's going to bring you into eternity, because it's appointed unto man once to die, and after death there is judgment. Amen. Is appointed. We have an appointment with death. Once to die. You can accumulate as much money as you want. You could buy as much homes as you want. You could have the biggest business as you want. All of these are good, because the Lord promised to bless us. And he said, I'll come that we may have life and have it more abundantly. So if God has blessed you with an abundant life, we give him thanks and praise that he has done you well. But I'm just letting you know that it will not take you into heaven. It will not give you eternal life. At the end of the day, you cannot translate all those things that you have accomplished here, whether it's education, whatever it is, you know, earthly things do not go into the spiritual realm. It's only what you do for Christ that will last. Make Jesus Christ your Lord and your Savior today. Now is the appointed time. He's saying to someone, fear not, I'm with you, but you must submit your life to Christ. You must give him your heart. You cannot be coming to God and you come in and you're asking and you are receiving, and because he promised the rain on the just and the unjust, you feel that all is well. All is not well. It is not well with your soul if you have not given your heart to Jesus Christ this morning. So he's saying here, fear not. The next thing he's saying here, he said, for I have redeemed thee, which is Isaiah 43. The first thing he said, I've created you, number one. The second thing he said to us, number two, he said, fear not, do not be afraid. The third thing he's saying, I have redeemed you. What is it to be redeemed? Amen. To be redeemed is to buy, you know, to somebody buy, they purchase. Amen. It's a ransom. And a ransom is something that has been purchased and paid for. Amen. So God is saying that he's paid for you. How did God pay for you? Because this is God Almighty that is speaking here in Isaiah 43 verse 1. He said, I have redeemed you. He said, I paid for you. To be redeemed is to be ransomed or to be purchased, according to the dictionary. Amen. So he has paid a price for you. And what is the price he has paid for you? He has paid a price, which is he gave his only begotten son, Jesus Christ, that whosoever believe on him will not perish, but he will have eternal life. Yes, he paid for you. He purchased you with the blood of Jesus, his only begotten son. It's a high price to pay that the Lord God Almighty, who is three persons in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, is the mystery of the Trinity. He came down on earth in the form of man
through his son Jesus Christ, who came, went to the cross, suffered and died, went to Calvary, was spat upon, was humiliated, was discredited. He still went to Calvary, suffered, his sweat became blood. There was nails in his hand hanging on a cross, and he went and he died, shed his blood for you, went into a cold, empty grave, rose after the third day, sits at the right hand of the Father, still making intercessions for us. What a mighty God we serve. Amen. He is worthy to be praised. Amen. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord this morning. Jesus Christ is Lord. So he redeemed us by his blood. The blood of Jesus is precious. Amen. We are washed from our sins by the blood of the Lamb, which is Jesus Christ. We are connected to the Father through the blood of Jesus. When we ask for forgiveness, when we ask God and we believe in our heart that Jesus Christ is Lord, he washes all our sins away by his blood. His blood has power. It never loses power. There's power in the blood of Jesus, and there's power in the name of Jesus. He has redeemed us by his blood. Amen. So he says here, I have called thee by thy name. That's another thing he did for us. You have a name that your parents gave to you, and you will know how it feels like when somebody calls you by another name and they were supposed to know this is your name. I have done it already. When I called somebody, I forgot the name, and for that moment I can't get the name, and another name pops in my spirit, and I said, and the person was not too happy. Amen. So when you have a name, you want to be identified by that name. He said, I have called you by your name. He's also given you a name. In Isaiah 45, he said, I named you and I surnamed you. Amen. He said, I know. He said, listen to Jeremiah. He said, before you were formed in your mother womb, I knew you. Amen. I have called you as a prophet to nations. Amen. So just imagine, before Jeremiah came into the stomach of his mother, when his parts was not formed, God knew him. And the same God who knew Jeremiah, the same God knows you too. Amen. He says, fear not, I have redeemed thee. I have called thee by thy name. Amen. He called us by our name. Amen. He has also given us a new name in glory. Amen. Well, that is going to be given to you as you make your way into heaven through receiving Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. Through salvation, we are making our path straight to get into heaven. Narrow is the way that leads to eternal life. Broad is the way that leads to hell. Many are on that road. You want to walk on that narrow road, so you would get that, you would hear, well done, my good and faithful servants. Even before you know that name, he has even given you an identity. He says, good, number one, faithful, number two, servant, number three. Amen. So he has already identified you. When you get to heaven, you'll hear, well done, amen, my good, my faithful servant. Amen. You want to hear that at the end of your life. As you take that chance and you're going to sit on a train, or even you're driving your bus, in your car, you're sitting in your home, and you expect the next morning you will be in the land of the living to go to do the things that you are doing in this life. You have an expectation of not dying that night. Amen. You want to have that same expectation that when you leave this world, that your soul will not go into spiritual death. You will have eternal life through salvation in Jesus Christ. Take a chance on Jesus. It's your choice, your salvation. It's your life. Amen. And you have a choice. He said, I'm setting before you life and death. Choose life. He said, number one, I've created you. Amen. Do not be afraid, whatever situations you're going through. He said to you, I have bought you back. I have redeemed you. And he's saying to you, I have called you. Amen. Which means he knows your name. He knows your number. He knows your address. He knows your situations. There is no situations that bigger than the God who have created you. Turn everything over to him. Many times we hold on to the problems and we speak the problems. We rehearse it in our minds. It is in our emotions. Amen. But we have not gone to God and say, God, I cannot handle this without you. I turn it over to you. And you said in your word, I'm standing on your word, which says, I would not be anxious for anything. Everything I am praying, I am going through, I'm making my supplication made unto you. But I'm thanking you before I receive what I'm asking. You know, and I'm having an expectation that you will do it. It will give you rest of mind. Fear not. In Jesus' name, amen.
Praise the Lord.
He said, I've called thee by name. And the last thing he said here, he said, thou art mine. You belong to God. Amen. You have an owner. Sometimes we know who we are. I'm a supervisor. I'm a police officer. I'm a registered nurse. You know, I'm a preacher. I'm an evangelist. I'm a nurse's aide. Whatever the world has identified you as, or whatever Christ has identified you, I'm a bishop. I'm a apostle. We have a name and we have a title. But God says, we want to know not just who you are, but you want to make sure that you understand whose you are. Who do you belong to? Amen. If you belong to God, then you know that there is nothing impossible with your dad. Amen. He is your Abba Father. He's your daddy. He is your father. He's your creator. He's your deliverer. He's your sustainer. He is your mercy for God, who's going to forgive you. He's forgiving God. He's a kind God. He's a gracious God. He's a loving God. You have to know whose you are. Who do you belong to? You belong to a God. Who is your shepherd? And he said in his word, though you've passed through any all sort of waters, he's with you. Amen. He will never leave you nor forsake you. Amen. Though you walk through the valley of the shadow of death, even he is with you. Amen. So when we look at this scripture, Isaiah 43 verse 1, amen, he said, but now said the Lord that has created thee, O Jacob, he has formed thee, O Israel, fear not, for I have redeemed thee. He's telling you, do not be afraid. I have brought you back. Amen. I have called you by your name. He knows your name. And he has given you a new name in glory. Amen. And he wants you to receive that name. The only way you can receive that name is by receiving Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. Amen. He said, thou art mine. God is a jealous God. Amen. He says it himself. He said, I am a jealous God. And he wants you to know this morning that even as he has called you, he has named you, he has redeemed you, he gave you an instruction, do not be afraid. He wants you to know that you belong to him. God is a jealous God. Whatever things that you are putting in front of him this morning, he wants you to release it. He wants you to put it subordinate to his name, to his word, to him, accepting him as Lord and Savior. He wants you to put him first place in your life and recognize that everything else in your life, they are just addition. All other things, yes, your education, yes, your children, yes, your husband, your wife, they are all additions to what God is to you. He's the jealous God. He wants to be first place. He wants to reign in your life. He wants you to have a relationship with the Father through him. No one comes to the Father but by me. This is the word of God. And no matter what you think that can replace God in your life, that you can come to God, and because he's answering your prayers, you did not give your life to Christ and you think all is well because prayers have been answered, that you are living a life, there is no tribulation, no troubles. But God is saying to you this morning that he reigns on the just and the unjust. Be wise. Bring yourself in alignment to his word. His word will never change. His word would never go return unto him empty. If you have heard this word this morning, Jesus Christ is saying to you that he is Lord. He wants to be your deliverer. He wants to break every chain in it that's holding you back. He wants you to put him first place. He wants to bless you. He wants to love on you. Amen. You might be saying, oh, you know, I don't have a mate today because today everyone is celebrating Valentine's Day. God said he wants you to love him with all your heart, all your soul, all your mind. Love your neighbor as yourself. Amen. That's the biggest love you can have. Amen. We sometimes look for love in all the wrong places. When we start with the love of God, it's rich, it's pure, it's measureless, it's strong, it will endure time, it will endure your problems, it will surpass your life. Long after you leave this world, his love will continue from generation to generation. He's a merciful God and he wants you to come in alignment with his word. Praise the Lord. Every day is an opportunity to make Jesus Christ first place in your life, to put him first place, to acknowledge him. He should be honored every day of our lives. Honor him today. Make him your Lord and Savior. And it would be the best choice you would make in your entire life. God bless you. Shall we pray? Father, in the name of Jesus, O God, even as your word go forth, O God, we want, O God, Father, Lord God, to be saved, to, O God, Father, Lord God, to know that we in the boat, O God, your boat of eternity, that we are going into, O God, Father, not a Christless eternity, but an eternity where we will see you face to face, Lord Jesus. I ask you, O God, for those who do not know you as Lord and Savior today, O God, that you said if we confess with our mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord, that you will draw, O God, someone today by your Spirit in the name of Jesus, that someone will say, yes, Lord, I know, O God, I have some fear today, and as I submit my life to Jesus, I know, O God, Father, I decree and I declare that all fear is gone in Jesus' name. I ask you, O God, for that one who said yes to Jesus today, that you'll wash them. You should, as they confess their sins to you, that whatever they have done, that, O Lord Father, Lord God, you'll wash them white as snow. Give them a clean heart, O God. Give them your Holy Spirit, O God. Give that one, O God, Father, their name written in glory. I know that heaven and angels are rejoicing because someone said yes. I do not want me to miss heaven. I've been. God has been merciful to me. God has been long-suffering with me. God has been patient with me. And today, I say yes. I put you first place, Lord. I decree and I declare with my mouth, Jesus Christ is the Lord. And everything else are addition in my life. That one who said, I put Jesus Christ first place. I ask you, Holy Spirit, to come and live inside that one. Teach them your word. Lead them by your Spirit. Oh God, Father, guide them to a Bible-believing church that will grow. They will grow and they will know your word, uncompromised, the truth of your gospel. That, Father, oh God, you will connect them to their connectors. That, oh God, Father, Lord God, will encourage them in the name of Jesus. That, Father, oh God, they will study your word day and night. That, Father, oh God, send help, oh God. Give them a pastor, oh God, a leader, oh God, after their own heart, oh God. A heart, oh God, filled with love, brotherly love, kindness, oh God. And a heart, oh God, that will teach them your truth in the name of Jesus. I ask you, Holy Spirit, to be that teacher. Oh God, lead that one as they read your word, not by might, not by power, but by your Spirit. We say thank you, O God, for we have been redeemed, O God. You know us by your name, O God, and we belong to you. I say thank you, O God, for salvation for someone this morning. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen and amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ is Lord, and he must be glorified in our life every single day. We must honor him instead of giving honor to the things that are not important. Make Jesus your Lord and Savior. Again, from Choice Gospel Radio, this is Evangelist Jennifer Pope. Tune in again on Wednesday at 7 p.m. where you'll hear Salvation and Revelation. Continue to listen to Choice Gospel Radio, your life, your salvation, your choice. God bless you.
Choice Radio. Jesus loves you and he wants you to know. Choice Radio. Study his word so you can grow. Choice Radio. Choice Radio. Your life,